Good evening. We begin with shocking new details in the alleged double murder of Jesse Baird and Luke Davies. Nine News has obtained the police fact sheet revealing the case against Constable Beaulamar Condon. It includes allegations of how he went about cleaning up a trail of evidence and how close Jesse's housemate came to uncovering the crime.
A time for the force to celebrate after one of the darkest periods in its history. At the Goulburn Police Academy today, 158 new police officers reported for duty after an official swearing-in ceremony. In 2018, Beaulamar Condon made the same oath, only to break it by allegedly killing two men, Jesse Baird and Luke Davies, and disposing of their bodies in surfboard bags.
This is a much bigger, prouder organisation than one person that's currently before the court.
And the facts that will be presented to the court paint a picture of the lengths that Beaulamar Condon allegedly went to cover up his crime. At around the time of the shooting on the Monday, a 000 call was made from Davis's phone. A male voice could be heard shouting, "Get out, f off," before the call was terminated. At 8 p.m. that same night, a housemate returned to the Paddington home and saw two surfboard bags lying outside near the roller door. They were covered with a tarp. The housemate took three photographs and prodded them with their finger, unaware there were bodies inside. In a statement of facts obtained by the Sydney Morning Herald, New South Wales police will allege that they found three cleaners in the process of cleaning the premises 2 days after the alleged murder. They had mopped half the wooden floor before police arrived and stopped them. Police will also allege they found blood staining consistent with a body bleeding heavily under the floorboards in the kitchen, a bullet hole and a .40 caliber cartridge on top of the kitchen cupboard. A post-mortem examination on the body of Jesse Baird has confirmed what police always believe, that he died from a gunshot. It will be alleged that shot was fired from Lamar Condon's police service weapon. An autopsy on Luke Davies' body is expected to produce the same results. Damien Ryan, Nine News.
And Damien Ryan joins me now at the desk. Damo, you have more extraordinary allegations contained in that report.
Absolutely, Georgie. It was Jesse Baird's mother who first raised concerns and the alarm about Beaulamar Condon. On the day before he was arrested, Jesse's mother contacted Victorian police and told them her son was being stalked by a police officer known only as Bo. She claimed he regularly turned up at his house unannounced. The police facts also state she was of the belief that if anything happened to her son, that Bo would be responsible. Now, these allegations are all part of the case that led to Beaulamar Condon being charged with two counts of murder. Geordie.
Damien Ryan, thank you. And a vigil is about to start at Darlinghurst to remember Jesse Baird and Luke Davies a week after their alleged killer was charged with their murders. Our reporter James Wilson is there. James, just describe the mood if you could.
Georgie, this vigil is being described as a solemn celebration remembering Jesse and Luke. We're at Green Park in Paddington, around 500 metres from the terrace where these tragic murders took place. And tonight is really a chance for the first time for friends and colleagues to gather together and remember these two young men, not for how they died, but for how they lived. This vigil starts at 6:30. It will be a silent vigil, allowing people to stop in and reflect and remember at their own time. There will be a slideshow for these two young men, as well as a condolence book. I've spoken to a number of people here who say it's very important to do this at this time, particularly ahead of the Mardi Gras weekend. Georgie.
James Wilson, thank you.